Rain is on the way, so it was time to do some harvesting a little. My little mescaline mix salad, that thing is blowing up. I just harvested this gallon bag, all kinds of different things, along with a pitcher full. French onion radishes. I'm sorry, French breakfast radishes. They're a little bit bigger. I should have harvested them a little earlier, but they're still very tasty. And also a nice big bowl of kale, which tomorrow we're going to get rain all day. I might try my hand at kale chips again. Got to keep trying, right? So anyway, that's a nice little harvest I just did. The chickens enjoying a nice rainy morning. That one's under the banana leaf. I think I was spotted. Just chilling this Saturday. It's a nice, just overcast, rainy day. So, on the agenda. My garage is trashed. I got to get all the Christmas stuff put away. Oh yeah, got some work to do. So, let's get going. So guys, I just started out with the frame of mind to put that stuff away, kind of straighten up a little. But now I'm getting all in depth. I'm pulling everything out from under here. Totally gonna go through this place. So, it's gonna look good after I'm done. Okay, so I'm guessing you gotta make more of a mess before you actually clean up. Because I'm kind of trapped in this one little circle I noticed. Holy cow. But look underneath. Look at all the space I'm going to open up under here. Maybe put some shelves. I actually want to redo this workbench, so it might be a good time to do that once it's all clean. So my little workshop area is definitely becoming a project today. But I cleaned out everything. I organized some bins, my extension cords. This is just a miscellaneous drawer. Down here is all different kinds of brackets and different bolts, like big bolts. Put the shop vac over there with easy access now to get it. But now I'm sitting here cleaning off my bench. And this whole space in here, in between the 2x4 studs, is vacant. So what I found is just some scrap wood. I'm gonna make some cleats to put on the inside, and then I'm gonna make some little shelves to go inside there, and that can like hold my spray cans and all this, you know, the WD-40, all of that, and all my different spray cans when I'm doing little woodworking projects. So this will help get the stuff off of the table, and it'll be put away in a nice little spot. So use those little gaps in between your studs. That's actually great shelving. Okay guys, so there you go. Little tucked away shelves right in between your 2x4 studs. That's awesome. And I got to play with my Bosch nail gun. I don't really ever take this thing out, man. I got it, I think, last year for Christmas and haven't really used it, so I'm gonna start using it more often, start getting some projects going on. So guys, while we're at it, I'm just gonna make this a video on redoing my workbench area or something, because now I'm taking down this white pegboard and I'm gonna make more shelves in between the wider gap 2x4s there. So let's just keep plugging along.
Alright guys, let's have a look.
Nice and organized underneath. Put up more little shelving in between the 2x4s. Organized everything up. Added some pictures, some of my birthday cards I've gotten from my family. Just nice and organized. Organized my tools. So yeah, it's looking good. Heck yeah. Wow. This looks really nice. Very happy with how it came out. But remember I came out here to do the Christmas stuff? Yeah, ain't quite got to that side of the garage yet. But we just look over this way. This is way nicer. Yeah, this is really nice. I like the way it came out. I'm glad I got into that creative aspect. Definitely looks good. Time to start doing some projects, get some stuff done. I still got a lot more to clean, but this is a nice start to it. New year, get everything organized, clean it up.
Sounds like someone laid an egg. You announcing your egg?
Morning guys, welcome to Rivera Urban Homestead. Today's video is just going to be kind of a hangout and chat for a minute about the New Year's resolutions that I am implementing. But these are mainly for in the garden and around the homestead versus like getting a gym membership and all that stuff. So the first one in my garden New Year's resolutions is a feeding schedule. Basically, right now I don't have a feeding schedule. I add my compost when it's done into the soil. You know, I use the worm castings and stuff, but I don't really have a feeding schedule in place for the plants. And I think that could be a reason why I'm getting mediocre results. I'm not getting results like even right now, my beans and all that stuff, mediocre. My kale, my lettuces, those are going good. But even the cucumber plants, they're pretty much done already. They just started dying out. So one thing I want to implement this year is a feeding schedule. So finding a water-based organic fertilizer and actually doing a feeding. I'm thinking maybe every 3 weeks or every 2 weeks. I'm not quite sure yet. But figure get some organic fertilizer going in there at least every 2 to 3 weeks. And then in between those, possibly doing some compost tea once my compost in that chicken run starts going. And that's another thing. Once I get that chicken compost into that garden, I think that's going to really boost my, especially the nitrogen, but boost up my nutrient density a little bit better. So first thing, sorry, I took notes at work. Yeah, I was writing notes at work on this and I forgot it at work. So I had my buddy take pictures of my notes for me. So that's the first thing, the feeding schedule. I think that's important to just keep feeding those microbes in there and keep that soil really, really going good. Soil quality is obviously a very important aspect of the garden. You gotta have the right stuff in that soil for them microbes and the organisms and the fungus and everything to live off of in order to produce the nutrients for the plants to uptake. So soil quality is a must. Right now I feel mine is fair. It's getting better every season, I think, as I start adding more compost and more organic matter to it. I'll continue with my worm castings, cocoa coir, trace minerals. That's going to be definitely the foundation of the soil, but I'm also going to implement a couple of other things. First thing is my chicken compost, like I'm saying. That's why I have the chickens out there for compost and for eggs. But once that run and that deep litter method really starts breaking down, we're going to get some really good compost out of there probably for the end of next season, I bet. So by the end of next summer, or by the end of this summer coming up, we should have quite a bit of compost in there to be able to implement into the garden for the next cool season garden. So I'm looking forward to that. But there is a few other methods that we're going to talk about. First thing I'm implementing along with the chicken compost is a mulch. I haven't really mulched much, so in the summertime it seems like obviously my soil dries out pretty quick because there's no protective layer on top, and that sun here in zone 9, it's hot and humid. So I think a thick layer of
a mulch. I'm going to use wood chips because my neighbor owns a tree company and he's going to supply me with wood chips. So I'll put those in about maybe 2 to 3 inches thick. That's going to help with the soil, keeping the moisture retention in there. It's going to help with keeping the roots of the plants a little bit cooler in the summer months than what they have been in the past. And also, as time goes on, those wood chips break down and become an organic matter that feed the soil and feed the organisms. So wood chips is going to be my mulch of choice, and we'll just see how that works as I get that implemented in the summer garden. Next method I'm going to be doing that's a little different than what I've done in the past is when I harvest out my garden, when I take out the plants, I'm normally pulling up the plants, the roots and everything, and throwing it all in the compost pile. This year, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut all the plants at ground level, and I'm going to leave the root systems in the ground. And what that's going to do, that's going to feed the microbes and all the organisms that are in the soil right now, and the worms and stuff too. It's going to feed them. It's going to keep the soil underground a little more aerated because it's going to have the roots kind of going through there. And so when you take them all out, you know, all that soil kind of sets and packs down. So we're going to chop the plants from now on. We're going to leave the root systems in there to decompose naturally in the soil. And that's just going to help, again, add organic matter right back into that soil. And we'll just compost the top parts either in the garden or we'll throw them out to the chickens and they'll compost in the chicken run. So that is another method to try and build my soil quality. And of course, topping off every season with the worm castings and the compost is going to help as well, obviously. And then the last thing I'm going to do to help with soil quality is a good rotation. You know, you want a root crop, then a fruit crop, then a bean crop, then a green crop. Root, fruit, bean, green. That should be your cycle. And what that does is that just helps, like, the roots take out this kind of nutrients, that fruits really target a certain kind of nutrients. So if you keep planting that same thing in that same soil, you're really going to deplete it. Really, it also helps with your pest control. If you keep planting the same thing, like tomatoes, I'm going to plant tomatoes in this bed every time. Once the bugs that eat tomatoes obviously find that out, they're going to lay their eggs right there in that bed, and next summer, boom, when they get up, there they are. So if you rotate it around, it kind of confuses them, it kind of keeps their cycles off. So it helps you out in the long run as far as pest control too. So a good crop rotation is something I want to try and really keep in mind as I plan the garden out from here on out. Okay, so there's a few of the new things I'm going to be doing for the new year in the garden. And now let's talk about just some new additions that I want to try and do this year throughout the 2017 year in the basically around the homestead. First project I definitely want to do, maybe not the first project, but one of the projects that I want to do this year is dwarf fruit trees. I want to start getting some fruit trees around this property. I have a few different areas I could put big pots or whatever I need to do, build some nice pots or something, raised beds, and get some dwarf fruit trees in here. I want to have my own fruits going. So that's definitely something we're going to do. So dwarf fruit trees, that would be awesome. It would be really nice to have a couple different little fruit trees around here. I just need to do some more investigating on what would be good in this area for the dwarf fruit trees, what kind of fruits do we want. So definitely a citrus. Obviously I'm going to do like either an orange or a tangelo or something to that effect. And I'm not sure. I'm going to do some investigating about that and where to go to pick up some good fruit trees. I know that I think there's a fruit tree farm across the state, so that might be a cool field trip maybe one day we'll take. Next thing is on the fruit line is doing a dragon fruit setup for the cactus. I definitely want to do that. I'm thinking back behind my bird feeders back here by that privacy fence. I just got to make sure that would be the correct habitat as far as sunlight and all that. But I definitely want to set up a cactus fruit section and let them cactus run around, and then we'll have some fruit off of those. What else we got? Probably three more chickens I'm thinking I want to add. You know, I had four. I really thought that would have been a good number for us. With one of them passing, though, I don't want to introduce just one new chicken to the flock. So I'm thinking at least two, probably three. That way that'll give us five or six, depending on what number I do. And I think that'll just maintain a good egg supply. It'll also maintain that compost, getting that run getting mixed up a lot better than what it is right now. With three chickens, they're out there doing their job, but there's only three, so I think we're going to add a couple more chickens to the flock this year. And also, what else we got, man? Microgreens. I have not put my efforts into the microgreens as much as I want to. I have all the supplies. I have the soil sitting there. I even have the sunflower seeds I've been talking about for, I don't know, a couple of months now. Just haven't really got into that process. So I really want to dive into microgreens a lot more this year. I want to get better at growing them, and who knows, eventually possibly maybe pick up one or two accounts to maybe just try and sell some in the future, or package them to where I could go to the farmer's market on the weekends maybe sometimes. We'll see. Microgreens is big in my head. I definitely want to get that going this year. Dragon fruit, dwarf trees. One thing I kind of just have up in the air, it's nothing set in stone, but thinking possibly maybe a rabbit hutch, getting a couple rabbits out there. That manure is a cold manure, which means that poop can go right in the garden. It won't burn your plants, and it'll just add some good nutrients. Whereas the chicken compost, you need to make sure that is, or I'm sorry, the chicken poop, you got to make sure that is composted down good. Or else it is a hot compost, it'll burn your plants. Just the high nitrogen in it. So maybe some rabbits in the future, just to add a little bit more manure compost to the garden. I think that would be beneficial. So anyway, guys, those are my different ideas for the new year out in the garden and around the property. As you saw yesterday, I made this beautiful setup. I really like sitting here right now. New shelves, just looks really cool. I put some pictures up and stuff. I like it. The reason I'm not outside on my front porch doing this video today is we actually had a winter night, so to speak. It got down to, I believe, 35 degrees, 36 degrees. When I woke up this morning, it said it was 38, but feels like 30. And it feels good, you know, we don't get cold weather here really, so it kind of felt nice to go outside and get that little chill. I miss that from Colorado. I mean, I was used to that, but not anymore. So I'm in the garage doing this video versus out there. It's kind of windy and it's still probably in the 30s, so. But all the garden's looking all right. Nothing died or anything. Nothing froze. Maybe we'll just go take a quick look out there before I sign off. And you can see how it's looking in January. Nothing that amazing, but except that big old tomato plant is still doing pretty good. So there's the New Year resolutions. Oh, I have one more. One more resolution. Hold on, let me show you. Say goodbye to the hat you guys are so used to me wearing. My uppercut boxing hat. Yeah. It's done, guys. This hat has seen a lot. It's all ripped up, all tore up. So the old familiar uppercut boxing hat is no longer. I found this one in my closet. It still has a good brim on it. Nice. See that? Bam. Looks good. This one, bye-bye. It was a good gardening hat. Let's go out to the garden real quick, take a look at it, see what's going on.
Yeah, so right now it says it's 44, feels like 37. So it's a little chilly and it's 10 o'clock. It's only supposed to get a high of like 58, I think, today. Anyway, it's still a beautiful sunny day. Let's go take a look real quick at the garden real fast. Again, this tomato plant is still doing beautiful. And we're going to figure out what kind it is. I have that one tomato off of it. I put plastic on it last night, just in case. But as you can see, tomatoes are still blowing up. We still got plenty of tomatoes. Really big, beautiful looking plant. The little tomato plant over here is doing good. It has a couple of tomatoes on it as well. Broccoli, we already harvested. Kale, I've been harvesting. That's just an amazing hardy crop. Bush beans, they all took a crap basically. They're gone. Look, we're starting to get some of the Chinese red noodle beans. I know it's windy out here. Hopefully you can hear me. Some Chinese red noodles. The snow peas are hit and miss, man. They're like dying at the bottom, but then getting more growth. But they were yummy peas when they were in there. Cabbages. Looking all right, looking all right. Looky there. Getting some little cabbages going on. Cucumber plant, yeah. I mean, the tip of it, this whole section looks nice and green, but look at it. Just totally got diminished, possibly from that mildew, the downy mildew, I think is what I got. This, remember this? This is my lime or lemon seed that I planted over a year ago. I can't remember what it was. But anyway, it, since I've moved it right here, all of this new growth, man, is all new. It's really looking good. I'm glad I moved it from the front of my by my bushes to out here in the garden. And then this green patch, it's looking amazing, dude. I just harvested a whole bunch of lettuce out of here again. Oh, look. A volunteer tomato plant. Harvested this whole bed again. So that's the second harvest I've cut off of it. And of course, I still have plenty radishes. Plenty of radishes. These are the French breakfast. Nice and cold. Then we got carrots over there. And also right here, I don't know what that was, but with those big old yellow leaves or flowers right there, I'm saying that might have been like squash that just kind of came up. I didn't plant it. I don't know. Hishido bushing onions are starting to get a little bit thicker. So all in all, we did have good success in the salads, and the carrots are still growing. We'll see what comes of them. The kale obviously is good. I'm just loving this tomato plant. And again, I know it's because of that brick behind it, keeping it nice and warm. Just a ton of tomatoes. So pretty too, man. Look at those. Awesome. Love it. Yeah, you like coming in the garden when I let you? Silly girl. Come on, let's go. Psst, psst.
All right, so two more things before we go. I want to show you one of my last New Year's resolutions that I have to do, and it's going to get done today. Get all this dang Christmas stuff back up in the attic so I could finish cleaning my garage.
It is still a mess over there. That's why I just like to sit here at my workbench, because it's nice.
And last thing is, let's go check out that tomato and figure out which variety that is out of that rainbow heirloom packet I got.
Okay, so here's the packet I got. It was from Gurney's, and it was the tomato heirloom rainbow blend. So it has seeds of equal parts black, pink, red, and yellow brandywine, Cherokee purple, green zebra, white wonder, and Nebraska wedding. So these are all the different seeds that are in this packet. I only planted a couple of the seeds, and that's what one of these is, that big tomato plant that we have out there right now. Here's the beautiful tomato that came off of it. Nice, big, pretty smooth in the surface. So let's try and figure out. I looked up red brandywine in the images, and I just don't think it's a brandywine. Those look a little more like rough textured and really red. So let's try something else. I think I'm shooting for this Cherokee purple here. That looks pretty close to this guy. So let's cut it open and see if that's what it is. Wow, as you can see, it's very meaty. Not a lot of seeds in this. This would make a great, like, paste tomato or something. Look at that. Just tons of meat. Alright, so what do you guys think? Cherokee purple or brandywine? Either way, I want to see how this tastes. Oh, wow. That has really good flavor. Whatever it is, that is a really good tomato. That would be perfect in sauces and stuff. Yeah, more images that I'm looking at, I'm thinking it is the Cherokee purple, guys. Really good.
Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Just kind of getting the New Year's resolutions going for the garden. Tasting that beautiful fresh tomato in the winter garden. Cherokee purple. I like that. I still have quite a bit of seeds in here. I think I'm going to get these started for the summer garden, and maybe we'll just do one bed just full of all these different seeds that are in here. Maybe we'll get a whole mixture of different tomatoes. Might be a fun project for one of the beds next summer or this summer. Anyway, you guys have a good day. I'm getting ready to watch some playoff games, and we'll see you next weekend.